wasn't in my time where I didn't love myself. I just got up in the morning and I did my own thing. Come on, I wasn't thinking about nobody else. How can you think about somebody else when you don't even find your own self worthy? But God comes with the power of the Holy Ghost tonight to tell you, you gotta get in a place in Him that you will be found worthy in Him, that you may minister to somebody else. When you stop being a homosexual, when you stop being a lesbian or a drunkard, come on, oh, we smoke like I was. You can't love nobody because you don't even love your own self. A lot of us say, man, we have done things in our life that we're not appreciative of. We don't like what we have done. A lot of things that some of the things we have caused on ourselves, some things are just because we're chosen of God. And things are coming to our life. Before my mother's womb, oh God, He placed me there. And He called me to be a apostle. He went on another journey, and when he began on another journey, the house was full. He entered into a house and he began to teach the things of God. Everybody was in the house, the Bible says. The Pharisees were there. Isn't that something? Come on, the scribes were there, and the doctors of the law were there. Isn't that something? Because the Bible said that light has no fellowship with darkness, and the darkness covered not here the light. Isn't it something that even though darkness hate light, but for some reason they keep being drawn to it? Oh my God, it's something about the light that even though you're in darkness, it still pulls you to be nosy and to see what God is doing. Let me break it down for you. There's fuck in your life that's in darkness. Lord, so they don't call yourself or say, I'm just checking up on you, but they got a nosy spirit. They're just trying to see if you still hanging with the Lord. Come on, yeah. They don't want what you got, but they just want to see if you for real. But baby, why you trying to check me out? God shaping me. God molding me. God turning me around. Why you say trying to check me out? God done changed my heart.
Yeah.
You better get in the presence of God and stop trying to watch me. Watching me, I'm on my knees and God changing me. Oh, hallelujah. And so the Bible declares here that he went into this house and it was full of the Pharisees and the scribes and the doctors. Amen. Because isn't that book something that book pastor that would come to your ministry, that we would come to your revivals and act like they want God? But they're really coming to the service to trip you up. They're really coming into the service to find out what you may say wrong so they can tear you down. After the Bible declares, amen, that the Holy Ghost is the truth. It can't lie. It only can tell you the truth. So anything that the Lord spoke, it was going to be the truth. But even though that we have truth, truth has revelation. That means it has to reveal the hidden thing. So even though we got Pharisees and scribes and doctors in the law, in the church house, they can't understand the revelation that's been preached from the pulpit. That all the doctors of law fool themselves. Doctor bishops and reverend doctors, chief apostles and master prophets. There's been a shifting in the atmosphere. That you're coming out the houses. You're coming down. chapters of the law, studied the Bible, but not chosen from the womb. Lord have mercy, Jesus. These doctors coming down. These chief apostles, self-made apostles, prideful apostles, some of them chairs full of pride. Thinking when you walk in the building, everybody ought to stand up.
Thank you.
Lord. Thank you, Lord. And it says right here in verse 18. Well, let me go over here to 17. Let me point something out to you. It says, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. Isn't that something? The anointing could be resting, and the glory cloud could be resting in that place. And it could be manifest through a vessel, but you not get healed because you're so stuck up within yourself. The Bible says that when you heal, the voice of God don't harden your heart. Some of you in the service right now, the heart, your heart. But if you just open up your spirit, open up your soul, God was present in this place. What would heal you? See, the Pharisees could have changed it. They would have opened up your hearts. The scribes could have changed it. They would have opened up your hearts. And the doctors of the law could have, oh God, they changed it. They had opened up your hearts. Because the presence of the Lord was in the place. Don't you understand that when the presence of the Lord is in the place, it can set anybody free. I don't care if you've been raped 3 times. I don't care if you've been molested. Open up yourself. It's not that people that you have come in contact with didn't have the power. It's because you didn't open up yourselves. It's because you didn't want nothing from God. See, I preached last night about Hannah. She had to be dangerous and she had to be determined. Because she wanted something from God. And you got to come to a place in your mind, in your spirit. I want something for God. And I know, God, if you do this thing one more time for that, I know it'll be changed for real. If you can get that in your heart and get that in your mind, I'm telling you, you'll be so amazed how He will create you all over again. Don't you understand when God sent Jeremiah down to the potter's house, the clay was marred in his hand. Don't you understand you got messed up in the hand of God? Oh, now better praise Him right there. Woman, you need to blink your eyes again because you're seeing it in the natural.